Good morning, everyone. This is Pooja Palapathy. I am working as IT and CT trainer in APSWRS Girls Narsipatnam, which is located in Visakhapatnam district of Andhra Pradesh. In my school, we have around 621 students from class 5 to 12. And there is only one teacher involved in CT, and nearly 17 classes were assigned per week. And coming to my paper, I have submitted with the title of Computational Thinking in Schools After COVID-19 Pandemic.
I want to give brief introduction about my school and CT implementation. In our school, we have students from economically backward class and who are located in remote village areas. Most of their parents are farmers and uneducated daily wages. Andhra government is implementing CT to students through Naipunya Vikasam project. And coming to the implementation of CT, since 2018 in Andhra, we are implementing CT with CS Pathshala curriculum to around 2 lakh students from 427 schools of Ashram, Tribal and Social Welfare schools. We are implementing this to students from class 5 to 12, and the main goal is to improve computational thinking, explorative ideas and reasoning skills. CS Pathshala is providing pedagogical and content training to teachers with customized curriculum. Due to COVID lockdown, we have digital classes instead of physical or regular classes. During that period, we assign tasks to students through WhatsApp groups. Some of the students shared pictures like these, and some of them sent written copies. These activities are done by using IT applications like Paint and MS Office. Also, I have created one mobile application and some videos on CT to share with my students for their reference. Coming to challenges, students' participation is very less in lockdown when compared to before lockdown due to lack of resources. After that, students attend school for 4 months, that is from December 2020 to March 2021. Some of the students have access to resources that I shared during lockdown, and they helped me out with delivering that content to other students after lockdown. Since October 2020, trainers from Andhra got trained on various programs like AP Showcase Event, TCS Go IT and Panchatantra Programming. The AP Showcase Event and TCS Go IT are conducted during lockdown, and Panchatantra Program was conducted after lockdown. Now I would like to give brief description about these training programs. Coming to the AP Showcase Event, in state level, some trainers got selected based on the CTIS 2020 abstract submissions to share their experience, and I got chance to share my experience, as well as I facilitated some presenters as a mentor. All 427 trainers from the state level participated in this event and made every session highly interactive. Trainers came up with various innovative examples on the CT concepts. I really like the live example given by Sonia ma'am using bangles on counting combinations. After lockdown, we implemented CT by making activities like animations and games using Scratch. Coming to the gaming part, we did activities on Sudoku, IT vocabulary, IT shortcuts and missing number pyramid as missing laptop number by using the concepts of key press and sprite click in Scratch. Coming to the animation, we did activities on patterns with real-time examples like sunrise, sunset, revolving earth for loop and some flowers, buildings, balloons for motif and tessellation. After that, we had advanced training program on Scratch, which is Panchatantra programming for 2 months, that is from mid-Jan to mid-March of 2021. From Andhra, we have 180 participants, and at the end, trainers submitted 149 projects. In these 2 months, we had 2 sessions per week with Panchatantra programming team. Now I will give short description about this program. There are different stages in implementing this program. In the first stage, students have to write their own script with dialogues and have to form as a team with trainer. After getting confirmation from Panchatantra programming volunteers about script and title, students can start their work on their projects. In the stage 2, students have to design their own sprites, backdrops, and have to record their dialogues. Then after, students can do their coding using sprites, backdrops, and vocals. The entire project should contain copyright-free content. In stage 3, we will submit the project and the evaluation will be done based on the rubrics. After evaluation, they will announce the selected projects and will give certification. We did a project on Raman effect and the title of the story is Magical Rainbow. In this program, we received Vibhushan certificate. Also, I got an opportunity as facilitator to help out other trainers in their projects. Coming to project implementation, students have designed their own sprites, costumes of main characters and backdrops of these scenes using iPad. After that, students started recording their vocals of dialogues as per the script. Then after, they started working on coding using the design sprites, backdrops and vocals. Now I would like to share my experience of CTE STEM 2021, which was organized by Asian Pacific Society for Computers in Education and Education University of Hong Kong. This conference was hosted by National Institute of Education and Nanyang Technological University. In this conference, we have participants from around 6 countries with 29 papers by 59 authors. From our India, we have submitted 4 papers and all got selected for presentation, in which one of the paper is mine. My takeaways from this conference are that how to integrate CT with other academics using activity-based learning. The final outcome of this conference is that my paper received the best paper award. Throughout this journey, I have CTIS 2020 program committee chairs, Venkatesh Raman sir, Sonia ma'am and Priyanka ma'am as my mentors. From bottom of my heart, I would like to thank my mentors, CS Pathshala team and CTIS 2020 team. Coming to the impact, students have improved their technical skills and reasoning ability. Students showed their enthusiasm by coming up with innovative examples. Students also improved their programming skills through fun activities. I really want to thank my mentor Premlata ma'am for supporting me throughout this journey. And finally, I would like to thank CTIS 2021 team for giving me this wonderful opportunity to share all my experience. Thank you.
Aishmeta Kakade, along with my friend Namrata More, express our warm greeting to this select gathering. We are the teachers from School of Scholar Beltaroli, Nagpur.
Today, we are presenting on the topic Algorithm Visualizer Scratch. In our school, we are having more than 1,000 students in the grade standard 1 to standard 10. Two ICT teachers, we are presenting on this topic, and teachers involved for taking computational thinking are 6. We have been allotted 2 periods for computational thinking. Now, to visualize algorithm in daily routine, we have asked students to give examples where they follow steps. So various students come up with different examples. They have given how to follow the steps when they are going out to play. So they have noted that and even shared the same in the class. They have also noted the steps which they are going to follow when they get ready for online classes. And same they shared with their friends in the class. As there is lockdown, so they are even helping their mothers in cooking and they are exploring different recipes. So few students noted the recipe which they are following. So one of them have noted how to make cake. So for that, they have written the algorithm. We have asked students to refer PPT 03P19, that is on Scratch intro. And then they followed the steps and created the same using Word, and then they followed the step for Scratch. As we are taking online classes, so even we faced few challenges. All the students are not having the laptop or PC with them. They are doing the practicals, they are doing classes using mobile. So they faced some difficulty in creating the story and game using mobile, as the screen is small and it is having some limitations. Few students face the problem of network issue during classes. So we are sharing the recordings so they can go through them and can understand what has been taken. So to explain impact of computational thinking in other subjects, I call my friend Shweta to take us to it further. Shweta ma'am.
Thank you, Namrata ma'am. As students has written algorithm for the daily routine activities, they have not stick to the limited topic or in the limited area. They have implemented same concept with the different subjects as well, like implementing a science experiment and solving maths word problem also. So for implementing science experiment, they have written procedure step by step. Solving word problem, also they have written algorithm stepwise. After writing algorithm, we observe that the number of students making mistakes while writing procedure for science experiment and solving mathematical word problem is less than they use the algorithm for the same. As they understood the concept of algorithm, they were able to solve a Weber's challenge task in very less time. EVS lab activity by standard fifth students. So here we can see that the students have written algorithm to explain the mechanism of sensory system. Mathematics word problem. Students have written algorithm to solve a maths word problem and they have shared screen in classroom. Impact. Students use Scratch software to visualize the algorithm which created for the following. Students have created a various stories and game to see to visualize the algorithm in Scratch. As Scratch provides the visual graphic interface, easily they can understand. Once they visualize the concept, they will easily understand that how algorithm are working step by step. So students have created Thirsty Crow, car racing, ping pong game, and farm animal introduction with their sound. So here you can see some glimpses of Thirsty Crow story created in Scratch. So one of the student, Kanishka, she is sharing screen and she is explaining in the class how she has written an algorithm to implement the Scratch story. Here is the glimpses, Scratch story. Also, students have created some games like car racing, ping pong game. Also, they have created a story for introducing farm animals with their sound. Story created in mobile using Scratch Junior. As we face the challenge because of this pandemic, students, those who are using mobile, for them, we asked to use Scratch Junior application to create a story or game. So I would like to share one game which is created by a student.
I'm lost. Anyone help me? Hello, I am a cute fairy. I will help you. Come with me. I can see my home now. Thank you, cute fairy. You are so good. I am a good fairy, so I will save the earth from asteroids.
this story, she has explained how that fairy is saving Earth from the asteroid. As the asteroid touched the red line, Earth get destroyed. Science experiment showing protein test. Students have created a science protein test experiment in Scratch. So here are some glimpses which shows the protein test. Solving maths word problem. Student also created a story which shows the how to solve maths word problem with the animation. Presence of starch in potato. Next science experiment. For that, student has written algorithm. Step 1, cut potato in half. Step 2, put 2-3 drops of iodine solution in, on the potato. Step 3, check the color of potato will is changing into the blue-black color. If color will change, we can say that starch is present in a potato. Here we have some feedbacks. Students enjoy this activity very thoroughly. They enjoy a lot while implementing algorithm into the Scratch. As they have seen the visual platform, they visualize the same concept, how step-by-step algorithm is working. They have written, one of the students has written, it was a nice or wonderful experience. I learned more about the coding and algorithm. It helped me a lot to understand a very important topic during this online world. It will surely help me in future for computer programming. It help us to implementing the computational thinking as well. So programming is the art of algorithm design and the craft of debugging errant code. So Scratch, it's all about the Scratch. Thank you.
Good morning, everyone. This is Mrs. Anagha Lothe from School of Scholars, Kolkheda, Kola.
And I, Mr. Bhanudas Tivhade from School of Scholars, Kolkheda, Kola.
We are very pleased to present our project on this platform in this third conference on computational thinking in schools. I would like to share my experiences with computational thinking along with a project run by us, wherein we have followed some steps in computational thinking to take our project to conclusion. The steps followed by us is about identification of problem. As in Atal, we are working on community problems. So one of the problems identified was the stinking urinals at public places. So we are working on this project. So the problem, after identification of the problem, we try to find out all the possible solutions. We have divided the problem in small chunks and try to find out all possible solutions to them. Then after getting the data collected on the possible solutions, we analyze the data and try to select an appropriate and workable solution to our project. While going on with this, we started framing a prototype of this project, and we tried to tried that prototype and updated it time to time by whatever challenges we have faced, and we have overcome that challenges and updated our project time to time. Then whatever shortcomings we have found after updation also, we ruled out with the help of application of conditional logic to the problem. Then after solving all of the problems, we have installed our project in our school on pilot basis, and we could get the successful demo for the same. Now let me introduce with our project. Considering the stinking urinals at public places, many of the people are visiting the urinals with no option to the public urinals. That is quite unhealthy or unhygienic because of unawareness only. So to solve this problem, we have framed a project that will release the water automatically through the water will be flushed automatically. Then the disinfectant would also be flushed, and then again water accordingly, the urine to be disposed of very properly, because this is one of the best solution to dispose of the urine. It may be creating certain foul gases that are producing the smell in the urinals. So our students have formulated a project on in which the automated flushing of water would be there, automated release of disinfectant would be there, then the level of ammonia or certain gases would be identified with the help of air quality sensor. Yes. We have programmed, framed a program that will release the water, release the disinfectant, will turn on the exhaust fan and try to get rid of this problem. Even we have given a thought to the water level of overhead tank also. So that will also be sensed, and accordingly it will give a signal to fill up the overhead tank so that there won't be any problem in flushing the water automatically. So this seems very simple, that whatever the project we have done, we have faced certain challenges during this. Now, Mr. Bhanudas will let us know about the challenges faced and the solutions which we have got.
So, the challenges are like that, automatic flushing of water. So, first we are searching how that water will be automatic flush out. Then for that automatic flushing of water, so we are finding the solution. So, we are inserted the solenoid valve. So solenoid valve, there is very simple, because the student also know that the solenoid means the electric current is passing through the solenoid, then the magnetic field will be produced, and that is induced current and induced EMF will be produced. So with the help of programming in Arduino, so if the Arduino give the current passing through the current through the solenoid, then automatically it will be start, means the flushing of the water, as well as there is the flushing of the disinfectant. So means through the programming that the current will be passing through the solenoid, and that all this will be happen, that valve will be open. The flushing of the water, as well as means when the flushing of the water will be there, if the ammonia level will be increased by the 470 above 470 ppm value. And disinfectant also will be, we are putting there the timing, that is a 10 second if the ammonia level is 470, and if it is a tolerant value, then it will be the disinfectant will be flush in 20 seconds. So in this manner the students have set the program in the Arduino, and the working is in this manner. So next is the maintaining the level of the ammonia. So because due to the pandemic situations, we are not implemented that project in the public places. So for that we are using the ammonia sample, and we are tested all these things, and we implemented in our school toilet also. Then the students are facing the challenge setting up the perfect water pressure. So initially in our school practically our tank is on the second floor, so near about that height is 35 feet, so that pressure is great, and therefore so because that pressure is not sustained by the solenoid, therefore the very simple key, we are taking the two pipes, so means that water pressure is divided into two, and one pipe is again divided into five urinal. So the pressure level is decreased, means whatever we required, that pressure will be there. Then high voltage supply also there. So that is again one challenge. So because Arduino required the below than 12 volt supply, but actually the supply is 240 volt, and the current is 5 to 15 ampere. So for that we have to set there the relay. Four channel relay, we can say that, and using that we are taking that supply, means that supply is below than 12 volt or according to our requirement. Then these challenges, one by one challenges are come, and we are finding out the solutions. Then again the electric safety in public urinals, so that is again one challenge, because still now there is the pandemic situation, and we are not implemented in the public place, but the students are thinking what problem, because they experience that much challenges and they are solving all the problems. So they are thinking if we implemented in the public places, then what challenges will be come, and then they are find out some of the problem, and they are finding the solution also. So to like that, to avoid the short circuit in the complete set of the except LED and screen, because LED and screen require the open space, or because it sends the gas, different types of gas. Therefore, LED and the screen are put outside, and remaining all components they are thinking we have to keep in the plastic box or inside the wall. But inside the wall, it is somewhat expensive. Therefore, they are using the all components are kept in the plastic box. So this type of number of challenges are come, and we are overcome practically, and we are thinking we will implement in the public places.
Now let us see how our students worked on the project. Let us have an view wherein we can see our children are working on the project.
We have programmed it in such a way that for 2 seconds it will release the disinfectant, for 5 seconds it will flow the water through urinals, and for 50 seconds exhaust fan will turn on, and the small fan will be on below 200 threshold for the whole time.
Now let us see that how this project has impacted in terms of our computational thinking. Now students have learned many things out of this project, because many of the challenges are there and they have tried to their level best to overcome the problem. Let us just summarize the things whatever we have done in that in terms of computational thinking, that the students have decomposed the problem. The big problem was divided into small chunks, considering the steps that can be followed, like what can be the way to automate the flushing of water, releasing disinfectant, checking of water level in the overhead tanks and everything. Then considering the challenges, students abstracted the possibilities from the data collected or the experiences they have gathered. Then by applying their computational logic to the problem, they can, and analysis of data, whatever data collected, the repeated applications of the solutions would be done. We've done, and we could design the program finally to work the project efficiently, and we could frame the algorithm for successful implementation of the project. And now we have already done the demo in the school and waiting for another demo in any public urinal. So hope you all have liked the project. Thank you so much.